There's so much water in Bangladesh that it's hard to imagine that for much of the year a lot of it's undrinkable. When it's not raining, the rivers in the coastal region become full of seawater, and the groundwater is also heavily saline. It's a problem that UNICEF is determined to tackle.
At this time of year, we're in the middle of the monsoon. There is water everywhere. Even in the rivers where we are now, the water is fresh. But if you come back in 6 months' time, you will find the water around us is saline. People suffer terribly. They have to walk often kilometers to fetch water, or they're buying water, which is very expensive. And often that water, not only is it expensive, but often it's not of good quality for drinking.
Now UNICEF has teamed up with scientists from the Netherlands and Bangladesh to address this problem. They've devised a new system whereby rainwater can be collected during the monsoon and then stored for later use underground. As it flows there, the drinking water displaces the saline groundwater and can be pumped out later on after the monsoon. This is the first time the technique has been tried in such an environment.
Good. Sweet.
We are standing at a place where we started a new resource in Bangladesh. So we are using pond water and rooftop rainwater to store it underground. You can see water trickling here, coming from that tank, and we have sands inside the well. So water is passing through this sand, and we are storing it in the natural storage underground. So this is the thing we are doing. So why we are doing it? Because water quality here was not usable. So because of infiltration of this rainwater and pond water, so we are creating a freshwater buffer underneath. So like 3 years ago, there was no source of drinking water here. Now people are getting water from this well here. And every day, few hundred people comes here and collect their water for drinking purpose.
Not only is the water cleaner and safer than other sources, but because it's held underground, it's protected from the cyclones and the floods that often hit this region. Since 2010, 20 test sites have been established. The users say that the water is cleaner than the sources they'd previously relied upon, and their family's health has improved.
We used to drink water from another well, but that water was dirty and made us ill. Now we only drink water from this new well. The water tastes better and we don't get sick anymore.
UNICEF now wants more people to benefit, and in September 2013 agreed with the government to extend the project to 100 locations. The next challenge is to work with communities to ensure that the system is sustainable.
Our commitment is to build these schemes in a way that they can be managed by the communities and operate for 10, 20 years until ultimately perhaps a public water supply comes. But for many, many thousands of people in Bangladesh, perhaps millions of people, this is 1, 2, or 3 decades away.
That's a long wait for those who are worst affected by the poor water supplies. And UNICEF hopes that other organisations will now copy its technique, not only in Bangladesh, but in other countries also.